You can host your own website on Google Cloud for free, and I'll show you how step-by-step, even if you never worked with cloud servers before. We'll create a virtual machine on Google Cloud's always free tier, install Docker, set up Caddy, and get your website live on a custom domain with HTTPS. Don't worry about hidden charges. I'll break down the limits so you can stay completely free. And by the end of the video, you'll have a secure website on a cloud server that you can experiment with and make your own. So let's get started. Okay, so get yourself over to cloud.google.com. You will need a credit card to sign up, but like I said, don't worry. I will go over the limits so you can stay within them later on in this video. But first, let's go to your Google Cloud console by clicking this button up here. And then this hamburger menu in the upper left-hand corner, click that. Come down to Compute Engine and then Overview. And we'll get out of here. And then we want to click on this box that says Create Instance. And now if this is your first time using Google Cloud, you'll probably see something here about enabling the Compute Engine API. So go ahead and do that. And once you've done that, we can configure our virtual machine. Now, you should be aware that there, and I'll have this linked below, there are these specific parameters, these specific specifications that we need to stay within when we configure a virtual machine, so that way it's always free every month to month. So as you can see here, we have to pick an E2 micro machine in one of these data centers. So let's go ahead and start with that. And I'll just keep this up on the screen here so we can reference it throughout the video. For the region, US Central 1 in Iowa is one of those, so I'm just going to keep that. And then as far as the machine type, we need an E2 type machine, and then specifically we want a E2 micro, which is going to give us that 2 virtual CPUs and 1 gigabyte of memory. Let's move on to the OS and storage and click this change button. And a lot of these operating systems are free and open source, so you can choose whichever one you like. I'm going to pick Ubuntu because I prefer that, and we're going to pick specifically the latest long-term support version, which is Ubuntu 24.04 LTS. And be careful, because our machine is an Intel processor, we don't want the ARM version here, we want the x86-64 version. So let's click on that. And then, as you can see, we can get up to 30 gigabytes of SSD storage for free as part of the always free tier. So we'll pick that. And we want to make sure that for the boot disk type, we have a standard persistent disk, as it says in the specifications. And then we can select that. Let's go to data protection next, and we will disable backups just because that they could potentially incur an additional fee. And then under networking, we want to enable HTTP and HTTPS traffic. And I do want to point out down here, I know there's a lot of confusion if you expand the network interface. You might think that if you upgrade your network service tier from premium to standard, you'll get 200 gigabytes of bandwidth per month. But that's actually not the case. This option is only relevant if you have a paid virtual machine through Google Cloud. What we are limited to, as the specs say, is 1 gigabyte of outgoing traffic per month. We'll talk a little bit more about this later. It does seem limiting, but there are ways around this with something like a CDN or whatnot. But for now, just keep the premium network service tier enabled. Under observability, we disable the install ops agent for monitoring and logging. Again, that could incur a fee. It is free to enable, but we're just going to avoid that. And then under security, we do not want a service account. And I don't think there's anything under advanced that we're going to enable here. Actually, if you do go down to provisioning model, make sure that you have standard selected as opposed to spot. Spot is the preempted version, and we need the non-preemptible VM. So just make sure you have standard and you should be good to go. But at that point, we have a monthly estimate that's around $7.31. Yours might look a little bit different depending on how many days are in the current month that you're enabling this. But like I said, we get 2 virtual CPUs, 1 gigabyte of memory, 30 gigabytes of solid state storage. And I will put this in the linked blog post just so you guys can be 100% sure that you are enabling a always free tier compatible virtual machine. So they have this command line equivalent code. And I'll put what mine looks like, and you can compare them side by side. Unfortunately, there's no way you can paste this in unless you actually do the command line. But this is what your configuration needs to look like. And if that is the case, we can go ahead and create our virtual machine. So go ahead and click on create, and that'll just take a couple minutes here. When that finishes, I'll catch back up with you. All right, our virtual machine is up and running. As you can see here, it says this instance is running. So let's connect to it, and we can do that via SSH. There's a couple different options. We're just gonna do SSH in a browser window. So that'll open up this one. And you'll see this pop-up that says allow SSH in browser to connect to VM. So click on authorize, and you'll have to authorize that through your Google account when the first time you do this. So go ahead and do that, and then we'll click on continue. All right, and now we are logged into that virtual machine in that remote data center in Iowa in my case. And what we want to do is install Docker. So we're going to set up a website via Docker, and we can install Docker with this command right here. And don't worry, I'll have all of these commands linked on my website, so you can just copy and paste from there. So what that does is download this getdocker.sh script, and what we want to do is run that. So we can do a sudo sh get docker, and if you're not familiar, you can tab complete to not type out every single letter. Hit enter, and that's going to go ahead and install Docker and Docker Compose. All right, that has finished. So we have Docker and Docker Compose installed. And the last thing I'm going to do is add our user, in my case, Tony, the Tony user, which I think does come from your Google account, the name on your Google account. But anyway, we want to add that user to the Docker group, so that way we don't have to type sudo every time. So let's do that. And now for those changes to take effect, let's just exit out of our SSH session by typing exit, and then we can come back in the same way that we did before. So open in a new browser window, and we won't have to re-authenticate with Google this time. That was just a once and done thing. All right, and we are back on our SSH session, and what we're going to do is set up the most basic Caddy website possible. We're just going to set up a Docker Compose file. So let's go make a directory called site, and we'll go into that directory, and there's nothing in here obviously, but let's make a file in there called docker-compose.yml. And in here, let's again paste this from my website. We are going to define a service. We're going to pull down the Caddy image, and we're going to just call it Caddy demo. There is an underscore there, it's not really showing up that well. But we're going to expose ports 80 and 443, which is HTTP and HTTPS. So to get out of here, Control X, capital Y, hit enter. And now we can do a Docker compose up dash D. The dash D is daemon mode, so it runs in the background. And that's going to go ahead and pull down that Docker container and start it up. We can confirm that with Docker compose PS to see the list of processes. And as you can see here, it is up and running. So now at this point, we are technically serving a website over the internet, and let's test that out. So let's minimize this. We have this IP address, not this one, not internal, the external IP address that we can go to in a web browser. And the reason this is happening, basically when you click on this link over here, it's taking you to an HTTPS version of your website, and we don't have that enabled yet. So let's make sure we're explicitly going to http://, the IP address. Hit enter. When you do that, you should see the default Caddy landing page. All right, so this is cool and all, but it is not secure, and it doesn't have a domain name. So at this point, what we want to do is associate a domain name that we own with this IP address. And if you don't have a domain name, go ahead and get one. There's a bunch of different places. I'll have something linked below for my recommendation. I have my domain names, some of them registered with NetIM right now. And we're going to use this one for the demo today, lulanta.org. So wherever you registered your domain name, go there, find something regarding the DNS settings or the zone file, and we want to basically add DNS record. So I can do that here by clicking this button, create a new record. And what we want to do is add in a record. The target is going to be the IP address of your virtual machine. So let's go ahead and copy that, and then we'll go back to your domain name registrar and paste that in. And then we'll confirm. Okay, so now that IP address is associated with my domain name. This next one is optional. We can add another DNS A record with the same target, but this time we want it to be from www.lulanta.org to our IP address. So let's go ahead and create that one too. All right, we got both of those. So let's go back into our virtual machine. And the next thing we want to do is tell Caddy we have a domain name associated with our website. So we can do that with a Caddy file. So let's use Nano, the text editor, to create a new file called Caddyfile. And then in here, you want to do something very similar to this. So put your domain name here. And then in between the two curly brackets, what this is saying is basically the root of our website is going to be served from the /srv directory, which is actually inside of our Docker container. So let's also go ahead and configure that, but let's save this. Control X, capital Y, hit enter. And let's make a public directory here with mkdir public, and then go into that directory, and then use nano to make a index.html file. I'm gonna paste in here a very simple HTML structure. It has a title for the website as a Caddy demo. It has some styling here, some CSS styling, a big header one element, like, comment, subscribe, a paragraph, and then a link. So let's see what that looks like on the web browser. So we'll save that, control X, capital Y, hit enter. And the last thing we want to do is modify our, let's go back a directory. We want to modify our Docker compose file. So let's open up that file again with nano. And at the bottom, we want to add a section here for volumes. So basically what this is doing is mapping that SRV directory to the public directory where we just created the index.html file. And same thing for the Caddy file. We want to map that into the Docker container. So let's go ahead and save that. And now what we can do is restart our Docker container to reflect those changes. So we can do docker compose down, and then docker compose up -d like we did in the beginning. And it looks like everything came up just fine. So let's go ahead and minimize this. And now instead of going to our IP address, let's go to our domain name. So lulanta.org in my case, and we can explicitly specify HTTPS, hit enter. All right, and there you have it. We have our website hosted on a cloud virtual machine, loaded from that index.html file with our styled header one element, a paragraph, and a link here, which actually takes you to my website where you can find, like I said, all the configuration files and everything that you need to copy and paste so you can follow along step by step. Now, the one big problem with hosting a free website on Google Cloud, as I alluded to earlier, is the fact that it only gives you 1 gigabyte of outbound data transfer per month. So let's say your website is 2 megabytes in size. That's only like 500 page views that you can have per month before you have to start paying, which I think it's 12 cents per gigabyte of additional traffic beyond the free tier. So it's cheap, but you can see how that could get expensive pretty quickly if you have a very popular website. So you can enable something like a CDN through Cloudflare. That's completely free. You'll probably 10x, depending on your cache rate, you're 10x the amount of pages that you can serve. So let's say 5,000 pages per month on the free tier. But if that is still something that's very limiting to you, you expect to have more pages, page views than that, more visitors. I recommend that you check out this video next, which has there's probably dozens of different ways that you can host a free website online. So it'll go over some of that. And I do keep a up-to-date list on my website, which I recommend that you check that out as well. Everything's linked in the description or on my website. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you in the next one.